Hi, you're listening to Kate Palmer.
I've just started to learn how to use Copic markers. This technique is a simple one that makes your image really pop from the background cardstock. I've found that using a combination of C00 and B0000 for the background gives a lovely result.
Start with the C00, which is the cool grey number 00. And all I do is very, very lightly outline the image in the grey. Now you can do this as you begin your piece or after you finish. It's probably easiest to do this once you've finished, just in case you make any little mistakes and you need to go with the blender pen to remove them.
You'll notice that I turn my paper a lot as I'm working. This is so that I can see the lines and don't make any little mistakes that can be avoided.
Right, so I've just quite quickly outlined the image. It's almost invisible. If you look closely, you can just see the hint of that shadow where I've used the C00. Now I'm going to be using the B0000 Pale Celestine. And again, just going over that same outlined area. Now, if you didn't want a blue background, you could use another colour for this. The grey works really beautifully with most of the colours that I've tried it with so far. With this layer, the background's become a little bit darker. You can see that edging a little more clearly. Again, I'm not looking for anything bright in my background, just to make a little less white so that the image is the focus piece. All I'm going to do now is take that same B0000 again. Now I'm going to trim this up quite close to the edges, so I'm not going to colour in all around the outside here. And starting from the image, just using light strokes, colouring just up into the point where you're going to cut until it's coloured in the way I'd like. I'm just going to work my way around. This side is a little patchy. So just go over that again. Just smooth out some of those lines. Now, if you'd like the image to stand out just that little bit more, going back with the C00, very gently outline in the grey again. And there you have it. A subtle background that lets the image stand out. And take some of the whiteness away from the card. So this is my finished card. You can see the background that I created just here. And when you add the colours to the image, it looks quite subtle. For this card, I've used a stamp from Sweet Pea Stamps.
I made this card for a colour challenge, and I had to stick to the colours of bright blue, bright green, pink and black. I may have coloured my mermaid in a different colour otherwise, but I really quite like the way it turned out.
I've mounted it onto some cardstock that I had, accented with some ribbons and some of these gorgeous little roses. And I've used my Copic airbrush to colour these small roses in matching colours, and these little tiny buds here as well. I've mounted onto a few layers of pink and green cardstock to finish. Now, I don't know if you could see when the card was flat, but it's covered in shimmery glitter. So I've used some of the Copic speaker pens to colour in, or to accent the black areas. I've got stickles on the cloud and a whole bunch of little micro beads on the accents. And I've used a little bit of the speaker pen on the lips and the eyes, and to accent the dress. So you can see how that background really makes the image stand out from the card without overpowering it. I quite like the way the hair turned out there. I was really pleased with my efforts at airbrushing using the Copic system. This was pretty much my first attempt. I think the flowers turned out pretty well.
Well, there you have it, a nice easy way to get your image to stand out from the background. If you'd like more specific details, don't forget to check my blog.